I know this is gonna sound kind of weird, but do you know anything about time travel?
When I speak of time, gentlemen, I'm referring to the fourth dimension. The fourth dimension is as real and true a dimension as any of the other three. Why is it that we usually ignore the fourth dimension? Because we have no freedom of movement within it. You see, we can move in the other three, but when it comes to time, we are prisoners.
Wait a minute, Doc. Are you telling me that you built a time machine out of a DeLorean?
The way I see it, if you're gonna build a time machine into a car, why not do it with some style? Come here. I'll show you how it works. First, you turn the time circuits on. This readout tells you where you're going, this one tells you where you are, this one tells you where you were.
Gentlemen, meet Joe Bowers, our first subject for the human hibernation experiment. With the human hibernation project, we will be able to save our best men, frozen in their prime, for use when they are needed most.
We're lying on your bed in the Grand Hotel, and it is 6 p.m. in the evening of June 27th, 1912.
Drink this potion, my lord, and thou shalt descend into the mountain of time.
To be quite frank, Kevin, the fabric of the universe is far from perfect, and that's where this comes in. This is the only map of all the holes. Well, why repair them? Why not use them to get stinking rich?
Yeah.
Are you also divergent, friend?
Nice night for a walk, eh?
Nice night for a walk.
Hey, kid, what'd you do, jump ship? What? Well, what's with the life preserver?
Clint Eastwood never wore anything like this.
Hey, who?
That's right.
These are heavy.
Yeah. Heavy metal.
Hey, why don't you watch where you're going, you dumbass?
Well, I'm double dumbass on you.
I believe our adventure through time has taken a most serious turn.
Into the pit with those bloodthirsty sons of more!
Who are you guys?
We're you, dude!
No way.
Yes way, Ted!
Damn it, you are handsome.
I was just thinking the same.
And he's rich.
Sigmund Freud. Boss?
Charles de Gaulle. He was a very famous French chef. Had his own television show. He showed you how to make souffles and omelets and everything.
Schwarzenegger Library?
Yes, the Schwarzenegger Presidential Library.
You maniac! You blew it up! Damn you!
talking about the classic paradox of time. Imagine, for example, I go back in time to meet my own grandfather. And we have an argument and I kill him. Now, if that happens, how am I ever going to be born?
Wait a tick. Basil, if I travel back to 1969 and I was frozen in 1967, presumably I could go visit my frozen self. But if I'm still frozen in 1967, how could I have been unthawed in the 90s and traveled back to... Oh no, I've gone cross-eyed.
He was prophesied to have destroyed the evil.
Didn't do a very good job.
I knew I could do it this time because... Well, I'd already done it. Does that make sense?
No!
After the report, we'll time travel back to 2 days ago, steal your dad's keys, and leave them here. That way, when we get here now, they'll be waiting for us. See? Whoa, yeah! So, after the report, we can't forget to do this, otherwise it won't happen. But it did happen.
What's rule number one?
No matter what. No matter how small, never change anything in the past. Nothing.
Somewhere in the past, the timeline skewed into this tangent, creating an alternate 1985. Alternate to you, me, and Einstein, but reality for everyone else.
Clatu, ferrata, nectar. Okay.
Well, repeat them.
I got it. I know your damn words, all right? Necktie, nectar, nickel.
Find out.